Hello, my name is Michael Pender and I'm Professor of Medicine at the University of Queensland and Consultant Urologist at the Royal Brisbane and Women's Hospital in Brisbane, Queensland, Australia. Over the last 40 years, there's been steadily increasing evidence that Epstein-Barr virus, EBV infection, has a role in the pathogenesis of multiple sclerosis, MS. In 2003, I proposed the hypothesis that defective CD8 T-cell control of EBV infection might predispose to MS by allowing EBV-infected autoreactive B cells and plasma cells to accumulate in the central nervous system. A crucial prediction of this hypothesis is that EBV-specific T-cell therapy should eliminate EBV-infected B cells from the brain and thereby prevent disease progression in MS and lead to clinical improvement. In 2013, in collaboration with Professor Rajiv Khanna at the QIMR Berghofer Medical Research Institute, we treated the first patient with MS with autologous T-cell therapy, EBV-specific T-cell therapy. The patient was a 42-year-old man with secondary progressive MS. Following treatment, there was clinical improvement and a reduction in intrathecal immunoglobulin production in the CSF, and this was sustained for 3.5 years after therapy. Following this, in collaboration with Professor Khanna and his team at the QIMR Berghofer Medical Research Institute and colleagues from the University of Queensland and Royal Brisbane Hospital, we conducted the first phase one clinical trial of EBV-specific T-cell therapy in MS. The goal of the study was to determine whether EBV-specific T-cell therapy is feasible and safe in progressive MS. We treated 10 patients with progressive MS with escalating doses of autologous EBV-specific T-cells. The treatment was well tolerated with no serious adverse effects. Seven of the 10 patients showed clinical improvement, six showing symptomatic and objective neurological improvement, together with a reduction in fatigue, an improvement in the quality of life, and in three patients, a reduction in intrathecal immunoglobulin production. So in conclusion, our study indicates that autologous EBV-specific T-cell therapy is safe, and further clinical trials are warranted to determine the efficacy of EBV-specific T-cell therapy in MS.
My name is Rajiv Khanna. I'm one of the senior authors on this manuscript, which actually reported the world's first clinical trial of T-cell therapy for multiple sclerosis. This particular trial is based on this whole concept of that there's a common herpes virus, which is called Epstein-Barr virus, which also causes glandular fever, is associated with the disease of multiple sclerosis. So if you get an Epstein-Barr virus, you're much higher chance. In fact, those people who don't have Epstein-Barr virus would never get MS. So there is some very interesting link, although not fully defined as yet, between MS and EBV. We have been working on EBV for well over 2-3 decades, and we fully have understood how the immune system controls this virus. So Professor Michael Pender approached me when he had proposed this idea that EBV plays a very important role in the disease pathogenesis of MS. And we had developed in our own laboratory a novel T-cell therapy. So it was a bringing together of two ideas, and whereas he had an idea that EBV is playing some role in MS, and we had developed this immunotherapy for necessarily not for MS originally for cancers. So we brought that technology together and were able to sort of test for the first time in the world a novel form of T-cell therapy to treat MS patients.